Welcome, my friends. As I'm cruising along in beautiful Switzerland, I'm going to talk to you about the Helite Turtle 2 airbag vest, why I got it and how it worked for me. Now, I was initially in the market to get new back armor. I've got the one that's integrated in my jacket. The coverage is pretty small, so I was looking for something better and bigger coverage. And then I came across these airbag vests and started doing research on them. And as you may know, there's two different kinds. There's the ones that release mechanically, and there's some that release electronically. And back in the days, those electronic released vests were quite expensive, but they are and were at the time still the fastest one to release, because they have a sensor and it detects really quickly if you're having a crash and it starts blowing up that vest. So when it comes to, you know, down to the millisecond, the electronic vests are quicker. But even though they have come down in price, there's a few disadvantages with those vests. The first one is, if they do deploy, you have to send them back to the manufacturer, at least the dealership, to get them sort of reloaded. That's a big pain, you know, if it accidentally releases. It can happen even on the electronic ones. That's a bit of a pain. Also, the ones that they sell, they don't have the same coverage as the Helite vest when it comes to air volume and area of protection. There's another very important thing that was important for me to get this Helite vest, is because the way it's done. You see, it's open and it's just clips through with the three clips here, and it lets airflow. And that was one of my biggest concerns with the aftermarket back armor that you wear underneath your jacket. It has to sit tight to your body in order for it to work properly. But that also means that you get really, really hot. So anything above 30 degrees would be unbearable in the vest that I bought. And so I was looking for something that actually gives me the safety, but lets airflow. So it sits over top and it's relatively loose. So my vents still work in the jacket. I've actually tried it in 35 degrees Celsius. And that's one of the main reasons why I picked this design. There's another advantage, and that's being able to reload it on the go. Now, this one comes with a cartridge that takes you 10, maybe 15 minutes to reload it if it does deploy on accident or if you have a crash. So that really works well. Those were the main reasons to decide for it. I tested it a little bit. Obviously, I tested it now on this tour, and I had 35 degrees on this tour, and it's worked really well. And then, unfortunately, I did test the crash abilities of this. I crash tested the vest. Actually, I crash tested my bike and myself actually today. I did a low sider on the Stelvio pass going down towards Bormio, and the bike slipped away under me, and it was a low sider, and the air brake vest deployed, did its trick, and it's quite tight, you know. It blows up all that air, and it keeps your neck straight, and it's almost hard to breathe, I have to say. But it really did the trick. Not that I really needed it, because I was at low speeds. The bike didn't look so nice after that, but I was at low speeds, and I know that it works now, which is really, really cool. I wasn't quite sure, you know, how good the release mechanism works. And the good thing was I had a spare cartridge with me, so I could sort of reload the vest and put it back on, and, you know, let's do the trick. I hope I'm not going to use it ever again. But yeah, I did a crash test. I'm not sure if the video comes out. I have it on video. Fortunately, unfortunately, I don't know. But anyway, this is the vest. It's worked well for me. If you're in the market for one, definitely have a look at this one. If you liked the video, give me a thumbs up, leave your comment in the comment section. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel to see more of these videos. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Ride safe.